Hi guys, welcome to Ahmad Logs channel. This is a GSM based home automation project. To turn on Relay 1, you need to send A1 command. But this will not work, and the Relay 1 will not turn on. For this project, first you need to register your admin phone number, and then you can control the relays from the registered phone number. The phone registration process is very simple. Just send R through SMS from the phone number you want to register. You will get the response for the registration process on serial monitor. You will also get response on your phone through SMS. As you can see, the admin phone number is registered. To register the second phone number, just send R2 equals followed by the phone number with country code. Make sure the phone number must be 13 digits long. And after a while, you will get the response back on your phone. Similarly, you can register up to 5 phone numbers by sending R3, R4, and R5 followed by the phone number. You can also get the registered phone numbers list. For that, send list command from your phone. And soon, an SMS will be received with the registered phone numbers list. The same process will be used for changing a registered phone number. Let's say I want to change the phone number stored at location 2. I will send R2 equals and then phone number through SMS. And after a while, the phone number will be replaced. You can also verify it by sending list command again. Next, to delete our already registered phone number, send del equals and then type the location of the phone number from 1 to 5. And the number stored at that location will be deleted. Next, I have labeled relays as A, B, C, and D. To turn on the relay 1, send A1 from your phone. And the relay will be on after a while. Also, you will get the status of the relay on your mobile phone. Similarly, you can turn on any relay. Next, let's check the status of relay 4. Send stat equals 4 command from your register mobile number. And the status of relay 4 will be received on your phone. Here are the commands to check the status of each relay. Del equals all command is used to delete all the registered phone numbers. And then, you can register new admin mobile number by sending R command. It is truly a GSM based project. It works without internet. And you can control the home appliances from almost anywhere in the world by sending SMS from your mobile phone. Next, here you can see the list of all important commands used in this project. Note that you can send all the commands either in uppercase letters or lowercase letters. It doesn't have any effect on the whole project. This project required SIM800L GSM module, 2G SIM card, 4-channel relay module, 3.7 volts and 1200 mAh battery, and Arduino Uno. Next, insert the 2G SIM card into SIM800L GSM module. Any 2G SIM card will work perfectly with SIM800L. Here is the wiring diagram. Here, I am using 5 volts power supply to power relay module and Arduino Uno. And I use battery for powering SIM800L GSM module. You may download the wiring diagram from my GitHub account. Here, I have connected all the components as per circuit diagram. I have connected the battery to SIM800L. Look at the status light of SIM800L. If it blinks once in every 3 seconds, it's mean the SIM800L is ready to send and receive SMS and calls. If you have any question or need some explanation, then just comment below. Let's move to the coding part. I have put the code download link in the description. This code does not require any external library. I have used 2 libraries here. First one is Software Serial Library, and this library is used to communicate with SIM800L GSM module. The second one is EEPROM Library. This library is used to store registered phone numbers. EEPROM memory is built into the Arduino microcontroller chip. You can store 1024 bytes of data on it. It is a permanent memory. And the data doesn't get deleted when the Arduino board loses power. That's why I have stored all the registered phone numbers in EEPROM. And this EEPROM library is used to store registered phone numbers in EEPROM chip. Below, you can see the rest of the code. And this all code is required to work this project smoothly. The code is available for free. If you have any question about the code, then just comment below. Before uploading the code to Arduino, make sure you have selected the correct board and COM port from Tools menu, and then hit Upload button. You can use Serial Monitor for testing. You can monitor all the events related to the project in Serial Monitor. If you want to debug the code, then the Serial Monitor will be very helpful for you. Be careful, SMS service is not free. You must have balance in your SIM card. Or else, you subscribe for SMS bundle from your SIM card network provider. You can get the USSD code for SMS bundle from your SIM card network provider's website. And then, type 80 plus CUSD equals 1 comma, and then inverted commas. And in between the inverted commas, type the USSD code. This way you can subscribe for SMS bundle from Serial Monitor. That's it. This is for today. Comment below for further inquiries. See you in the next video. Bye.